Good morning, salt shakers and friends. Encouraging Word, Saturday Heart to Heart with Pastor Albert Tan, prepares us for Sunday. Tomorrow is the Lord's Day, a day of rest, a day of recreation, a day of worship.
A blessed morning and a wonderful and joyful day in the presence of the Lord. Today is Saturday Heart to Heart with Pastor Albert. It's also the 101st. Encouraging Word. And you can see by now, since first started, I've not cut my hair for a long time. Today, let us first read the scripture from Matthew chapter 22, verses 37 to 39. Jesus replied, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind." And this is the first and greatest commandment. In this verse, we find Jesus referencing the three areas in which our love, the love of God must be demonstrated. Number one, it is our heart. This refers to the center part of our life, the spirit, to the passion of our very being, to desire God above all things. Number two is our soul. This is the emotional part of our being, where our love is being felt emotionally and expressed emotionally as well. And finally, our mind. Intellectually, we must love our God too. Jan Wilkin, author of Women of the Word, says, "The heart cannot love what the mind does not know." So we have a responsibility to know our God by the application of our mind to the study of the Word of God. But I want to focus on loving God with all your heart. My first experience of the Holy Spirit as a 10-year-old boy was the liberation of my soul to love God with my emotions. Many love God with a true passion and with their mind, but may never have been liberated into the experience of loving God emotionally. I remember in the 70s as a youth at one of the Bible camps the church used to hold annually, there was one song that caused the youth to kneel down and weep before the Lord. It was the song, "He Touched Me." Sovereignly, the Holy Spirit swept through the congregation of the youth and touched each person personally and individually. Such an experience can never be easily forgotten. And it's experiences like these that remains the strength of the Pentecostal worship and its ability to touch lives in radical way. So let's listen to the song again.
Shout it while he turns.
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and evermore. Amen.